Hi, welcome to this Carbon Mods video tutorial on carbon fibre skinning. What we're going to be doing in this tutorial is showing you how you can cover an original part made of wood, plastic, metal, or pretty much anything else in a thin layer of carbon fibre and coating that in a clear layer, making it look like it was an original carbon fibre moulded part. What we're going to be using in the tutorial is two components. They're both wing mirror parts of a car, but obviously we've got one that's very, very simple and one that's significantly more complex. But we're going to be going through the process on both of these to show you how you achieve good results using the kit. Right, let's quickly go through what you get in the kit. You get the base layer, which is a black base layer, and a clear layer of epoxy. The hardeners works with both of those two, and they mix it at 2-to-1 ratio. You get a piece of carbon fibre, which is a metre by 300 millimetres, approximately 3 foot by a foot. The other items that you get, polishing compound, range of abrasive papers from a coarse to a fine, that's bringing the part up to its final level of polish and finish. Mixing cups and sticks, two pairs of gloves, two brushes, and a booklet on how you do all this. Some other items that you're going to need to complete the process are a hairdryer or a low temperature heat gun. Reasonably accurate set of scales, kitchen scales are nearly always absolutely fine. Decent set of scissors and some cloths, and if you're going to be lacquering your part, rattle can of lacquer. Right, let's get started on these parts. So what we're going to do on a clean part, start rubbing it back with a small piece of the coarsest sandpaper that you get in the kit. Just make sure that when you're rubbing it back, you get right round any areas that the carbon is going to contact, and in some cases if you go a little bit further, that's absolutely fine. What we're looking to do is create a surface that the primer layer can really bond onto. Right, so as we can see, all keyed up now and ready for the next stage, which is putting down the base coat. So first thing to do is mix up the base coat. So that's the black one. Just pour enough to cover the parts that you're doing.
Then we'll add half the amount of hardener to the amount of base coat and give it a remix, making sure you get it all off from the edges of the pot. Thoroughly mix it, spend a minute or so doing it, and then we're going to be brushing on a thin coat right over the surface of the part. You don't want to be putting too much on because it'll run and dribble down the part, so just an even coating right the way around, making sure you've got it on all of the places that the carbon is going to be in contact with. So now just set those on one side and wait for them to go to attack, which is when it's sort of sticky to the touch but nothing comes off on your finger. It normally takes about 3 hours to get to that sort of stage. So we'll cut the carbon fabric. You want to make sure that the carbon's a reasonable amount bigger than the part. This will give you chance to, you know, not be so critical on where you've placed it and wrap it round underneath the component. So this is the critical stage now. We're going to line up the carbon really straight and even, working from the centre of the part. Just drop it lightly on and rub it down from the centre outwards, keeping it lifted off contact any areas, making sure it doesn't bridge over any gaps. Then just pull it around underneath the part. It'll be sticking quite firmly to the tacky base coat that we've already put down. Trim off any excess, and then we'll go around and tape the excess down underneath the part. That way, when we coat it with the clear resin, there won't be any sharp fragments at the back. It'll keep it all nice and neat. So just a little bit of masking tape or sellotape, pretty much whatever, just to hold it back. So now we're doing exactly the same thing on our other mirror, which is a lot more complex, but as you can see, the carbon will sort of manipulate and shape around the part quite easily. Again, cutting off any excess, and then we'll just be pulling it around and sticking it down onto that base coat. Again, just like before, wrap it underneath the part, trim off the excess, and then tape it back.
Now that your component's got the carbon fibre all over the surface, it's ready to put on the first clear coat. So we'll mix that up to the same ratio that we're mixing hardener to, 2-to-1.
To apply the clear resin, you want to do it in much the same way that you did with the black base coat, just nice, thin, even layer, not building up too much.
Once you're happy that your parts have had a thin but thorough coat, set them onto one side, and for this first coat of clear layer, you're going to want to leave those to go to a full cure.
At this stage, we've probably left that part for around about 8 hours, maybe overnight, just so it's hard to the touch, and we're just scuffing over with the coarsest sandpaper, the 120 grit, to take hot points, high spots, basically just even out the entire surface. We're not looking to get it to a flat stage, we just want it consistently scuffed back over the top. As you can see, right over all the parts, and now it'll be ready to take on further coats of the clear. Again, exactly the same mix, using the same clear resin, brushing on nice, thin, even coat onto the part. So here we are, doing exactly the same thing on the other part. So we mix up your resin, not to mix it too vigorously, because you can get small air bubbles in it and they'll brush onto the part. To get rid of those, a quick blast over with the hairdryer, and that will pop the little bubbles on the surface. Leave that on one side to go to a tack, and then you can apply subsequent layers of the clear. You'll be applying two additional layers of the clear each time, just letting it go to tack before you finally do set it on one side and let it go to a full cure, which ideally you want to leave probably for a full 24 hours before you start rubbing it back. So starting again with the 120 grit sandpaper, wet is ideal, a little bit of soapy water just to stop the paper from getting clogged up. Over a small block, it'll help it flat out evenly, and just now you're looking to rub back just to the point where the surface is totally flat and even. Really take your time, you don't want to be too aggressive or rub back too far, because you'll break down into where the carbon is, and that'll mean you'd have to apply more layers of the clear to get it back up to the stage where it was. So rub it back evenly, work around all of the corners, really put in the time here. This is the point at which you can't do any shortcuts. You've got to really make sure and ensure that the part is smooth and flat all over. If you give the component a little bit of a wipe down at this stage, it helps to identify any problem areas, and then you can move on to the next grit. It's a good idea, whenever you're changing grits, change the water. It stops any of the previous abrasive paper, any granules, scratching the surface of the part. So work all the way through the different grits, right the way up to the 1200, which will give you a smooth satin finish all over the part. Now we're going to show you the two alternative options of finishing the component. One will be a clear coat lacquer, a spray can, and the other option is to use the compound that comes in the kit and polish it by hand up to a full gloss. So to lacquer it, we'll be masking up the component all over any areas that we don't want the spray to attack, and just put on the clear coat lacquer just as you would any other part. Any automotive lacquer is absolutely fine, just follow the instructions on the can. Two or three layers is normally enough, and often a quick buff and polish at the end. If you're not using lacquer, all you need is you get a little bit of rubbing compound in the kit, just on a rag, and work in a circular motion, buff the component up to a final shine. On this part, around about 5 minutes of this, we'll see it up to a full gloss. As you can see, excellent results can be achieved using either method of finish. This complete kit is available to buy online at www.carbonmods.co.uk, where you'll also find lots more information, tips and tricks on this and other similar products.